Hello children, good morning. Let us study this poem, A Thing of Beauty, which is written by famous British poet John Keats. He belonged to the Romantic period, so he is called as Romantic poet. Her romance refers to love, but it's a love of nature. These poets of Romantic period loved nature. They equated nature with God. They found godly presence in nature. They found a lot of happiness in nature. They wanted people to return to nature. When the world was filled with greed due to industrial revolution, a Greek legend happens to be the basis of this poem. In this Greek legend of Endymion, there was a young shepherd by the name Endymion, who had a vision of Cynthia, the moon goddess. And this young Endymion makes a resolution to go after her and seek her. In this quest, he wanders through the forest and under the sea. In the poem, the poet tells us that beautiful things bring immense pleasure and delight. The poet explains that God's creations provide happiness as well as energy, enthusiasm. The things present all around provide us with plenty of reasons to feel happy. Moreover, the brave soldier's stories bring inspiration and enthusiasm to the life. Beauty is a heavenly tonic. It is like an endless fountain of nectar. Beauty can come in various forms, and it can give us good health, remove sadness from our lives, which will ultimately result in everlasting joy. And that's the reason why the poet says, "A thing of beauty is a joy forever." So let's study this poem in detail. Let's go through the introduction that is given in your textbook. The title of the poem is A Thing of Beauty. You must know the title and the poet. And who is the poet? John Keats. Is a very popular British poet, and you must have definitely studied one of his poems in lower classes. So you may be familiar with the name John Keats. John Keats, he belonged to Romantic period, to which William Wordsworth, Lord Byron, P.B. Shelley belonged. So I'm quite sure you must have read the poems of some of these poets like William Wordsworth or P.B. Shelley. But John Keats died when he was very young. So he died at the age of 25. He was a British Romantic poet. Although trained to be a surgeon, Keats decided to devote himself wholly to poetry. Though he did his studies in medicine, he wanted to continue with the profession of poet. Keats' secret, his power to sway and delight the readers, lies primarily in his gift for perceiving the world or understanding the world, perceiving the world, looking at the world, and living his moods and aspirations in terms of language. The following is an excerpt from his poem Endymion, a poetic romance. The poem is based on a Greek legend in which Endymion, a beautiful young shepherd and poet who lived on Mount Latmos, had a vision of Cynthia, the moon goddess. The enchanted youth resolved to seek her out and so wandered away through the forest and down under the sea and saw the earthly beauties by which he was very much attracted. And he saw that nature is very beautiful. And there are many things which are beautiful, but what we require is eyes, which you should keep it always open to see beautiful things, which is all around you. You are blessed with a beautiful campus and see the beauties all around you, and you will really feel there's so many beautiful things which will take away all the sadness of life. Before we read the poem, there are two questions which are being posed to us. What pleasure, what happiness does a beautiful thing give us? Beautiful thing provide us happiness? You have to think over it. And what kind of pleasure you derive when you look at a beautiful thing? Are beautiful things worth treasuring? Is it worth keeping? Is it worth recollecting in your mind? Is it worth of a treasure? Are beautiful things worth treasuring? So here we are concerned with aesthetics. We are concerned with beauty. Is it that beautiful things provide us happiness or pleasure? Think over that. And let's try to understand what the poet has written. So let's interpret first. These first stanza. So I'll at first recite the lines and then I'll explain to you each of them. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. A thing of beauty, a beautiful thing, is a joy forever, provides us happiness for all the time. Is a joy forever, provides happiness for all the time. What does the poet say? The poet says that beauty stays forever and it provides us happiness forever. Its loveliness increases. The beauty keeps on increasing. It's a lovely, it's a beautiful, it's a charming. So it's a charm. It's loveliness, it's a beauty that keep on increasing. It doesn't go on reducing. How its beauty keep on increasing? You see a beautiful thing. You think over that beautiful thing. After 2 days, when you remember that beautiful thing, how do you feel? Probably you enjoy more. So it's a beautiful, and maybe after 1 week, the beautiful moment in your life, something beautiful that you have seen, beautiful landscape, maybe of the sunset, beautiful natural landscape, Somewhere you had been there and you had seen that during the rain, you had enjoyed the rain. Probably that beauty. After 1 week, when you remember that moment, how do you feel? You'll definitely enjoy more. And that's what the poet says. It's a loneliness, it's a beauty, it doesn't keep on reducing, but it's a beauty keeps on increasing. Maybe after 1 month, probably you'll enjoy more that moment, that beautiful moment that you had in your life. It will never pass into nothingness. It will never become nothing. That means it will never fade away. It will always remain way, maybe in the hinterland of your heart or somewhere in the mind. But will keep a bower quiet for us. But what will be the result of that? It will provide us a pleasant shelter, kind of covering to get rid of the sadness, that happy moment which will cherish that moment again and again if it comes. When you are gloomy, when you are melancholic, then it will provide quietude. It will make you calm and quiet. It will be like a bower, it will be like a shade. When it's very hot, you take shelter under the shade. And how do you feel? What is your mood? How happy you feel? How calm you feel? Similar kind of calmness you will get when you think of those moments, when you cherish those moments. A sleep full of sweet dreams, and as a result of that, when you remember all that sadness that is there in your life, all that melancholy that is there in your life, that will all go away and you will have a sleep full of sweet dreams. Not nightmares, but sweet dreams. That means you will have very sound sleep, you will have heavenly pleasure, and you will have good health, because you will not be tensed up. And when you don't have tension, you will definitely have good health and quiet breathing. The poet says your breathing will be normal, you will be able to breathe quietly. When you pant, you make sound of your breathing. When you are in tension, you start breathing fast. But you will have very quiet breathing. When you will have quiet breathing? When you will have peace. So the result of this beautiful thing will be that you will be at peace. The perception of the poet regarding beauty is that it never goes off with the passage of time. Rather, it beautifies more and more. For the poet, beauty is like a beautiful shady tree under whose shade all the creatures can sleep peacefully and enjoy good health. This is the most important stanza. And you remember the first line of this poem is quoted often. A thing of beauty is a joy for you. You must have heard in the past. Now you know that this is written by John Keats. Now let us understand the rhyme scheme that is used in this stanza, because we have to know deeply about the poetic devices that are used in this poem. And at first, we'll take up the first stanza to understand the poetic devices used by the poet. And we'll try to understand those poetic devices too. Poetic devices, we also call them as figures of speech. So, in order to make it beautiful, the poet uses beautiful expressions and he uses different poetic devices. So, he uses the speech figuratively. Now, let's take up the first one, that's a rhyme scheme. Which rhyme scheme is used in this poem? When this poet wrote, a lot of criticism was there. But now let us see the rhyme scheme that is being used. How will you find out what kind of rhyme scheme that is being used? So first of all, you find out the rhyming words. So you have to concentrate on the last word of the line. So what is the last word of the first line? Forever. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. So the last word is forever. And forever is rhyming with what? It's a rhyming with never. So forever. Forever. Ver. So r. So it's rhyming with never. Forever is rhyming with never. And they are like. So forever a. Never. It's the same sound that is produced there. So therefore again a. We'll come to the third line. In the third line we have keep. It doesn't rhyme with never. So for that what should we do? We'll write b. So first one forever r, r a, r again a, keep p, b, keep. Now keep is rhyming with sleep. So what will write? A, B, B. What will write there? A, B. Keep, P, B. Sleep, same sound. So that's why B. So here, A, B, B. Now full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. It's a different sound here. So you can write C there. Now first four lines just see here. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Forever. A, B, B and C. A, B, B, C. If it's first stanza you can write A, B, B, C. Or you can write A, B, B. Okay. Have you understood the rhyme scheme which is used by the poet? The poet has used the rhyme scheme of A, B, B, C. Okay, that's all about the rhyme scheme. Now let us see any other poetic device that is used by the poet here. Which is that another device that is used by the poet? Let's see here. Now here the poet says bower quiet. And bower quiet refers to a quiet shady part in the garden. So shade bower. Bower means shade. That shady part which makes you calm and quiet. So bowering. So here the comparison is of what? It's comparison to a non-living thing. So it provides you calmness. What shade is providing you? Calmness. So that is the example of metaphor. Bower quiet. Then there's one more example that is of sweet dreams. Sweet dreams means happy dreams. So sweet dreams, that is also an example of what? That's also an example of metaphor. Bower quiet, sweet dreams, both these are the examples of metaphor. So let's see what is given here. A beautiful thing is a source of eternal joy. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. A beautiful thing is a source of eternal joy. Its loveliness grows or its loveliness increases with the passage of time. And its impact, its impression that is there on your mind, its effect never fades away. It is as soothing as a cool shade. It is as comforting as a cool shade. It never passes into nothingness. It gives us good health, sound sleep and mental peace. It provides the beholder with a haven of tranquility and solace. Thank you. Goodbye.